comes out to be $11.52 an hour. So I guess if I'm gonna pay her $12 an hour, I'm gonna have to cut her hours, that's all I know. And I did cut my Veterans Memorial $1,056 and my service officer school $200 in an effort to help pay for her salary increase, but evidently that didn't make any difference. So I hope you will reconsider on that or tell me what I can do. The other thing is, there's no money for a new computer, but I guess you said you might buy that in a blanket.
Yeah.
The only thing is, I might need a little more money for my computer software because a new computer will require new software for compatibility. We do the best we can. Postage is gonna be tight. And we do the best we can on that, so, I mean, like I said, my main concern is fire, so appreciate any consideration you could give me on that.
When you, like, when we grouped together the computers and that, I would suggest that you put in the software also, that it's gonna be needed in that cost also.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, if you can put together, you know.
There is some software, like Adobe is on there. I got a few little utility programs that I thought needed to be updated, I'm trying to add those too.
I'm gonna request today, after a meeting, that we put out an email or something, letting people know to get what they actually need, what software they need, so we can get some kind of.
Get a format.
Program. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Morning.
Morning.
Thank you for the 7% raise for most of my employees. I do have a question on why my office manager on the creek received a 4% increase. That's my major concern for the department.
The reasoning for that was that a first deputy, we feel that she needs to be equal to or around the same pay raise as the first deputy. So giving her that 4% keeps her in line with.
But she's making well under the first deputies.
No.
That's
Actually,
not
making a little bit more.
A little more.
She's still above the first deputy.
I'll review that. I didn't think it was.
Yeah, the new first deputy pay is 38.086.
And she is at 38.483.
About $400.
Keep mine short as well. Again, to reiterate where everybody else said, thank you for 7%. You guys obviously know my journey to get the office administrator position a little bit higher. That's kind of a request that I know you've heard by everybody today, but it's a challenge. I have to look at when that position is vacated by Gloria, someone else coming in, attract the position. So I just respectfully ask that you guys review the 26-29 to take her to where she would be somewhat in range for what we're trying to reach. So again, thank you guys for what you do. I know it's not easy. A lot of headaches, a lot of meetings. So other than that, board members, I know I asked for a $10 raise per board member. It's hard to get board members. If you guys can review that, I don't know that any boards got raises, but if they did, you know, it's hard to get people to step up and represent the community. So not that they're doing it for the pay, but it's something that offsets a little bit. So other than that, thank you guys for everything.
Yeah, I don't think any of the board was
Yeah, I understand. So that's all I have. Thank you.
Thanks, Karen.
Thank you.
Thank
We have that on the ARPA list.
We have that on the ARPA list, and if, and when the email goes out, now I will see to put together a package of the.
Okay.
I don't think the council will probably be in favor of the ongoing cost year after year, but I would like to see the package that the previous administrator brought for, to buy the 24/7 chairs, that are a lot more expensive than to have a rotating chair that you have to cost year after year after year after year.
Basically, I just wanted to thank you guys for the raises. The only line item I had an issue with would be the fuel line item. It's made my vehicle, or where I can take it home every day, the commissioners did. It's gonna cost me, if I drove it every day that we could work without the holidays, it's gonna cost me, that $4 a gallon would be $720, you'd give me $750 for all year. And I don't include what I spent this year, because I haven't been taking the vehicle yet, or it's been, was it $430, and I've actually got another $100 of receipts to turn in yet, so, gotta be paid in October, so. I was, the $1,200 was probably gonna be low, because I turned that in before they made it a vehicle, or taken a vehicle as well, so. I can try to do with what I can my budget, but I'm maybe looking for an addition.
Well, I think that the general consensus of the council was, yes, it may be considered a vehicle vehicle, but the management of that vehicle is somewhat up to you. It doesn't mean you take it home every night. Potentially, if you've got a, let's say, an 8 o'clock meeting the next morning, that's justified to take the vehicle home.
But doesn't the commissioners make policies? You guys are just supposed to do the paying of the stuff.
Well, we do the budgeting. We appropriate the dollars, you know.
But they're the ones that made the particular vehicle.
Yes.
So, I mean, they're the ones that have, that make policies and contracts.
Right.
And we have to look at the aspect of, what if every department came in and said they had a vehicle, we want to take home a vehicle?
We don't have, I mean, basically, the people that have them are taking them. Because the health sanitarian is, and Cameron could if he wants, but he's only 6 blocks away, so he's decided not to. But I'm the only one that's not. One that's taking home every day to the highway department. I mean, I know they're on call, but we got a, our supervisor lives in the county, so does he need to, you know, do that? So, or have them going home more than I, because they got people on call, takes care of the calls too. They drive big one week, so. But like I said, I'm just looking at, I'm making, looking for additional. Thank you.
I have a question for Cameron. Are you deciding not to have the take-home vehicle?
I haven't started it yet until we get all our stuff.
Well, you need to tell it to Jan, because it'll be on your payroll.
I haven't done it yet, because I still work with your uniform stuff, so that's when I start.
I know, but you still need to talk to Jan, because she's got a bonus and thing.
Okay, do you have to, do they claim that they drive and?
Yeah, they have to do the log. We just, I've just been busy to, I mean, I know Donnie's got a log. I'll talk to you guys about it later.
Is the fringe benefit a function of mileage or?
Personal use. Kind of taking it back and forth.
I know, but is it paying how many days or how many much mileage? Is it just a flat?
Flat
rate?
Flat rate, $3 for fringe benefit. But I'll talk to you guys about it.
And the reason why I request Mike, because I get calls the last two Wednesdays at 2 o'clock, I get, if it's something that needs to be looked at right now, like the one last week in Radnor, it was basically, if I didn't go, it was gonna turn into an issue, so that's the only reason other than if I need to get out there, you know, there's things that need to go get looked at all the time. I get called at 7 or 8 o'clock at night, I get called on weekends, so it's nothing that I'm asking this, other than what I've explained to that, you know. So that's kind of the reason why I'm asking, but I just have not started that yet until we do things out of that, so.
About the mileage law. As far as the sanitary thing is, and they've
a couple of the things that we wanted to kind of reiterate or, and or speak to a couple of notes. Look into training provided by the state. I know that you're already doing quite a bit of training. Look at that provided by the state. And I think we've told that that runs, as far as the deputies go, you know, the people that you call, I know oftentimes some of the, you know, first responders are probably, or they could be already at the scene. And I know that
they can't take them with me to store them though, usually.
Correct, yes. I'm aware of that. And the vehicle, obviously, going back and forth to Burlington, you need to have the vehicle with you. In case you do happen to get a call, just, you know, try to be conservative with that as best you can. As far as additionals, I know that we spoke to the commissioners, I believe, Monday on a cooler and things such as that, that we may be looking at some of the higher funds for. We'll try to keep a very close, and additionals across the board with any department. We're going to try to keep a real tight handle on a lot of the additionals because we are running up to the end of our envelope. The money that's coming in and the money that we're spending out. And I will also say, we gave a 7% raise last year, another 7% raise this year. I know the 7% doesn't directly address the inflation rate that we all are being impacted with. But I think, honestly, a person would be somewhat hard-pressed to see county of our size getting back-to-back 7% raises. So I'm awfully proud that we were able to do that this year. We'll see what the years hence bring, and if we have any easing out of inflationary rates, see how incomes will be looking into the future. But we thank you for everything that you guys do. Like I said, this is not an easy task. You know, we've got things such as a jail, a potential new ambulance garage that we're looking at. We've talked about and kept in the back of our minds the potential of the Abbey Libby trial. Probably at a minimum, that's $1 million trial. If it's a death penalty trial, it could be $2-3 million. We just don't know, and there are literally millions of dollars of unfunded liabilities out there that we have to consider and try to keep, because I don't think there's any of us in this room that want the county to take a loan out to cover expenses that we may incur. So, yes?
I just have a question. Guys, ever considered talking to someone about, everybody talks about all these grants that are out there, hiring a grant writer on the contingency that they get paid
by the grants
according to the kind of grants that they get, or get paid out of the funding for those grants?
That has been discussed in a number of different settings. Technically it wouldn't, for all intents and purposes, maybe other than Social Security and PERF, the grant writer for the county could write for anything.
Right.
And I know a lot of other counties do have that, and it has been considered. I don't know that it's been looked at somewhat of a, probably a joint council and commissioner decision, but I think that that's an excellent idea. It's even been brought up.
Pardon?
The
commissioners have discussed it, but not at me.
Okay. All something that should be visited and or revisited, whatever that case may be.
You have council.
Right, right.
Did help us look into the EMS.
The EMS garage.
More expensive than.
And, you know, it was brought up, I think there's a few people in this crowd that remember the old Unigov. It's, you know, I think Tracy hit the nail on the head when she said, preface us sitting down for this budget. We have to begin thinking outside the box. You know, just because we've done it X, Y, Z way in the past 30 years may not be the X, Y, Z way forward. And, you know, I applaud people thinking out of the box. And it's not just us seven here. It's you guys as well. You know, we all have to work together. If you guys come up with an idea or a thought, you know, don't hide it. You know, bring it to us and we'll take a look at it. I think that all of us, you know, more minds make better decisions, I've always felt. And, you know, maybe we look at down the road, you know, Delphi, Flora, Camden, Burlington, everyone, you know, funneling resources together. Not for sure how that would work, but funneling resources together to have a county-wide police force, you know, just some of these different thoughts that, you know, people go, oh, that would never work. Maybe it would. We don't know. But, you know, thinking outside the box and looking at alternatives that are there, I think, you know, helps everyone. Yes.
Just a question, Scott. I kept hearing that you're planning on adding this to the ARP and this to the ARP and this to the ARP. Is that joint meeting that you guys have coming up with the commissioners, is that for the development of an ARP plan?
That's part of it, yes.
Okay. It's just every meeting I said it, and there's been other departments coming in asking for money, and there's been some of the communities that have come in and asked for money.
Right.
And just in the back of my mind, we've already gone through that one.
The calculator keeps.
Yeah.
The receipt tape gets longer.
Yeah.
And when they did make the plan, they want it to be for the whole county when they spend that money. So, commissioners have to be on board too.
All right, I just wondered if that was.
Yeah.
So is there, on that subject real quick, so we're having this meeting on the 7th. Is that just discuss how the commissioners and the council, their idea of setting up the plan?
One last comment is that, you know, we are one of the, I'm not too sure, we're not the only county that still has a frozen levy. So that might be another area that you need to look at, thawing the levy out, because I know several counties have done that. So I'm just throwing that out there because I mentioned that to Jackie. She wasn't in favor of that, but I'm going to talk to her again about it and just see.
Like I said, I think we might be the only county left.
We are.
So that's
we are.
What I thought. But still has it.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Seventh of November.
Thank you.
raise the rate, but unless you raise the line, they're not getting a raise. I've said that numerous times. That's why I said, why are we not giving a 7% on that line item?
Technically, it's a wash.
You act like I've never said that.
Well, the custodians is one place that I think it's going to really affect, because they have a set schedule that they have in line. They cannot just say no more out, you know, less hours. I thought he was going to bring that up, but with them to get a raise and then cut the hours, that's a hard thing for him to adjust.
Well, it sounds like it's a hard thing for anybody to adjust. But personally, I would rather see the 7% go to the full-time employee, you know, be able to give more to the full-time employees than to the part-time employees. And I know that sounds awful, but.
Doesn't sound awful. Sounds like prioritization.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Change the range all you want. Like, unless you give them more money, they're going to have to cut their hours, and that's not a raise.
And so that raise you gave the custodian, is going to have to work more. I mean, you know what I'm saying? It's that's one that I really think needs to be changed. That's my personal opinion on that.
Tracy reran calculations. The clerk?
Okay.
So what about the paramedic part-time, the 22 from 25, 8? I don't remember that discussion. We didn't, but.
I don't have it written down anywhere.
I didn't write it down.
So he's here at 18 right now, so.
My recollection was we were going to put 7% more and do whatever he wants. Like, he can pay him whatever he wants to pay him. We're going to put 7% more. That was my recollection.
Well, I don't think we should just let him pay whatever they want. We need to set a rate.
Well, I mean, we do have to set a rate, but anyway. Yeah. Are we going to, the question is today, are we going to change the budget?
Dead day.
Yeah. And I'm not in favor of changing the budget. So. We can have that discussion about pay rate on salary discussion, on salary ordinance.
Yeah. I mean, we gave the 7% raise on the line item, so.
And where was this at? The part-time paramedic?
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's a management decision. How you want to use that money?
Literally, on the part-time EMT and the part-time paramedic, we gave more than he was requesting dollar wise.
Well, not on his second request.
Right. Yes.
Part-time paramedic.
Yeah, he requested 55,196 on the EMTs. We gave 56,146, and then on the paramedics, 70.
But his. I mean, to your point, though, his first budget request wasn't that $22 an hour.
Correct.
And was at that lower amount. So, I mean, he evidently thought he could do that. So, if that's how he wants to manage his department, then let him do it.
So, you're saying the 74 was on the $22?
The original budget request was off. Was assuming
22 at least.
Yeah, 22
and
to 20.
More. Oh, okay, I gotcha. There are a couple that will have to be changed a little bit that I don't think it will. Bottom line. No, just had some fun.
not to give her the raise, I concur in the fact that, you know, we do this, we'll be playing catch up with something like that percentage.
I'm just saying, we could put money in a separate line as a placeholder, like stipend that is not funded, so that the correct payroll could be tracked, and then at some point they could be switched back together. I don't know that that's a good idea, but it is an idea.
That seems cumbersome.
What?
I would hate for that one department to get so far behind.
Well.
And I know you're saying squishing it, but you know, this budget's hard enough to keep track of.
That's why.
I don't like to stay consistent.
Yeah, I think.
The other caveat to that is, we agreed to pay the recorder more than we pay the other elected officials, with the exception of the auditor, so there is, it is a higher paid position, so.
Yes, auditor, and then the clerk, and the assessor gets extra.
Well, the assessor gets extra, because she's, well, not.
Right, but she does get that, so I mean, it's.
We have to.
I know that.
The day is coming, I foresee, that you're going to have to pay elected officials more money in order to get in here people that are needed and educated to do this job.
I would like to back that down to your people in the office. Once you get them trained and they leave, that's where the raises should be. And I hope in 24 that you guys realize that, because we're losing people.
But we're losing people for $10,000 to $15,000, so we can give 20% raises, and that still is not functional.
I mean, I know one of the deputies went to the private sector for $10,000.
And my girl left for $10,000.
But we can't compete with that.
I mean, you just can't. And,
okay, can't stop that, and I don't regret her for going, but the people that are applying do not have the experience that I need. That's where I'm coming from, and I guess I do.
But I think.
What experience? What experience?
It would help if they had real estate.
I'm looking at your position. When you're done in your 4 years, I can tell you right now, in this day and age, the chances of getting an educated auditor for.
Slim to none.
Hence the reason that we had 7 auditors in 3 years.
Exactly.
That is not the reason. No, I don't want to say why.
The reality is that can happen. I mean, that was unfruitful for the county.
And I.
It just blows me away that you need no education.
Thanks.
And I think that it's.
I didn't say you didn't have any education. You have many, many years of experience, which is the same thing as education.
You still have the deputies that are training to maybe be in every office, I'm sure. Maybe not a lot of them, but they're training, and they'll say if they come on, I don't know.
It's a new day and age.
I think it's probably always been.
Deb Lowe's been around that situation.
Huh? Deb Lowe doesn't live in this county, and neither is her hot tub.
I think it's always been that way.
What's that?
I said, I think it's probably always been that way, that you're not going to be able to hire anyone. I mean, whether it's 2022 or 2002, you're not going to be able to hire someone off the street who has the knowledge and or education or experience. somewhere in the courthouse, if they've never been in the courthouse previously.
Well, I'm worried about.
What Beth was saying, that most areas have a deputy that, or two, training for that squad, unfortunately, but.
But like real estate, it would be nice if they had some real estate background.
Some experience, of course, yeah.
And, because Tara did.
Okay.
Carroll County just needs to plan a money tree.
Pardon? The clerk was the one to state the system.
Yes, yes.
So are you going through to see if you're gonna change anything?
And that will just ask if anybody wants to, has any opinion of changing any of them.
The only one that I would consider is the recorder's perpetuation.
Would be mine.
Yeah, I would choose to have about a point. It's not part of, not part of the general fund.
I would be interested in that.
Is that fair to the rest of the four county people?
You could say, well, all county general people, but, you know, this is different money, but I really wouldn't let people look at the custodians. Because they just have a set routine, and I know you can change that routine, but things are hard now. But anyway, that's fine. So what are we doing now?
I think a lot of departments need a little bit of restructuring, like Doug did. I think that needs to be looked at, in a lot of them.
I think the professional clerk to be.
You're gonna get raise that?
It's gonna, if we give the clerk, it'll be just like this year, we're gonna have every department in here has to put additional to match the clerk.
She's part-time, only working 20 hours.
What?
I think.
Huh?
What do you mean in the clerk?
I'm, excuse me, recorder.
Perpetuation.
Recorder, yeah.
And they have perpetuation.
I mean, they're not gonna care that she's paid out of perpetuation. Everybody's gonna be in here saying, it's not right.
We don't have a perpetuation.
Yeah, we don't have perpetuation, and this isn't right, but we got one part-time person making more than everybody else, or you gave more than everybody else.
I will tell you.
I agree with Doc in general, that it's like, that it's not, I mean, it is, it wouldn't make a difference, but like, it's just, unless you're just gonna open up floodgates, it's gonna end poorly.
I will tell you that at transfer station, she has an appointment today, but she said no complaints, and she's one of them that you did that with, and she said that would work out fine for her. The treasurer, I told her, so she's gone, and she said, she said she was fine from 11 to 15, and I said that they did not increase your part-time, and she said, that's okay, I always have extra anyway. So there you go. But that's what she said, and I don't really mean to, I don't want her to be punished by that next year, because I said she had more money, please. But that's what she was okay with it. So a lot of them are going to be okay with it, I think.
You have to remember that position there was not a position 3 years ago.
What?
In the recorder's office.
Was it 3 years ago?
It was when I first came in, and she has been during that, and so.
Two.
I understand.
Is she coming to, is she gonna be in the scanning, redacting thing, coming to ARPA too, is?
That's, I mean, and that's the thing, like, another thing, specifically to that point, when does it end? Like a part-time person?
Are we gonna sit here for 20 years and go back and scan, or can we?
Like, I mean.
That was presented to you guys by the recorder.
No, but she didn't, but Tracy very specifically asked the recorder.
When will you be caught up?
If you spend this $200,000, or whatever the number was, I don't remember what the number was, say it was $5, it doesn't matter. When does it end? When is the job done? When is the, when do you plant the flag and say mission accomplished on scanning old documents? And she wouldn't answer the question.
I mean, I have a hard time realizing.
Go back to who's looking in, and then they would take it back, or write all the information.
No.
I thought that's what she said.
That's not my question.
I mean, that was my question, and like Donnie, he answered the question. In his proposal, his will be all caught up and finished.
And that's what she said. She did say that.
Well, because Tracy said, why, how does it take a whole person to maintain something that is done forever? And she goes, well, you know, there's more scanning to do, and then she asks the question, well, what?
And the assumable reason why is because when this is finished, the part-time person will be done.
Right.
But she said there were gaps, didn't she? She said there were.
Well, she went back to the, I think it was the 1800.
My point is, why wouldn't you just say, this is how much it costs to be done forever?
Yep.
And if you were really about getting the job done, you'd say, this person will be done, I don't need them anymore, the job is done.
That's interesting. Solve the problem so it doesn't come back here.
Yeah.
So she might not need the hours, is what you're saying.
That's what I was saying.
Okay.
Well, I don't know. I mean, because people don't answer these questions clearly because they want more people. I mean, like, there's always, I need more people.
I can't justify somebody in here just to answer the phone when they're at lunch or when both of them should have to be sick at the same time. I mean, that's, those are very few and far between emergencies that just happen to every department. Okay, so all four of you are gonna make a motion or something saying that?
Yeah, there's a motion to be made.
Okay, so recorder, Snod, going to be, right?
Yeah, the motion, second.
What are you doing? Oh, we have to vote on this?
There is no motion that I'm aware of. I didn't make a motion.
Okay.
I make a motion that we, it stays out of.
We don't have to make a motion.
I didn't think we had to do that.
Yeah, we don't need a motion to change.
Okay.
I think we need to go back to custodians here.
Well.
Has that been decided?
What about the clerk? Are you gonna just leave her raise?
Yeah, as is.
Okay.
Gotcha.
Page 17 on custodians. So the only thing we did here, we left line items the same as last year, but we just moved the range.
$22,046 is the budget from this year. The utilization in 21 was 14,887. So, I mean, there's
money there.
There's
plenty there.
I mean, there's 30% unutilized.
Well, I just wanted you to check it.
Yeah.
So the reassessment, that's an annual contract maintenance.
That's $600.
That's what I'm saying.
She can transfer $600.
It's not that much.
Or maybe it's $1,000, but her budget utilization was only 90% on a $250,000 budget. She can transfer $1,000, so.
And then,
does anybody, I mean, can anybody rationalize what she's saying with the postage? I can't get there.
I could.
So I'm saying that, I asked her if she had the same amount of postage every year, and she said yes, but I can't seem that to be true, because if she's putting that postage, she's saying she bought $10 worth of postage. She only used maybe $8. So she put back that $2 over the past so many years, so she hasn't needed postage as much the last couple of years.
But now she put it back. She bought it.
Right.
Kept it.
Right.
But how do you put it back if it costs $12,000 every year?
That's what I mean. How?
Yeah.
If her mailings are the same every year, it should be the same cost unless.
They should be.
Unless there's a jump in stamps.
Well, the only thing I can think of is that, like, you have multiple, which is, I hope is what she's doing, is that, yeah, if you have 20 parcels, she's sending one letter.
No, she does. They know. She said that they're trying to put four in.
They can put five in each envelope.
She does do that.
Right, so I mean.
So I see what you're saying, though, that she doesn't send out $12,000 every single year, because it's not showing in the budget that she used that much.
Right, and so, like, this exact conversation happened with the treasurer's office when she went to this, and they do mail multiple things in one envelope. So my hope is that she would refresh the planning and maybe kind of sharpen her pencil on this, but right now, the way, if it's run, it's run less, but if it's run the way that the budget request is stated, it will be less efficient than current budget expenditure.
Okay, I brought 22 with me, which covers 20. No, I'm sorry, I brought my 21 with me, which covers 20. And in reassessment, as of July 31st, 2021, she had spent nothing. We had given her $6,000, and the year prior, she had spent nothing.
And that's what she's saying, but
right.
What we're saying is,
so in 220,
if you send out the same amount every year, your postage should be around the same amount. So
not if she keeps. I can see what she's saying. Say she had $10,000 and she's already had $4,000 from the year before.
But how did she have that $4,000?